Welcome to Time Tunnel Radio.
This is the Kraft Musical, starring Al Jolson, with Oscar the Vet, Lou Bring and his orchestra and chorus, the Kraft Choral Club from Chicago, and our guest, Clifton Webb.
So keep on looking for a bluebird and listening for its song. Whenever April showers come along.
Good evening, folks. This is Al Jolson in the Old Kraft Music Hall. Well, next Sunday's Easter, and that means all the women will be out. Not yet. Next Sunday's Easter, and that means all the women will be out in their new bonnets. You know, last year, Hedda Hopper wanted to have the most unusual hat. So she wore one with a cage on top with two little bunny rabbits in it. And you know, before she could get home from the Easter parade, she had 27 more hats. And now, folks, a song written by my good friend Harry Axe that just got to be number one on the revival parade. And, folks, here's one thing you won't believe. This song was dedicated to me, Babyface. Babyface, you've got the cutest little babyface. There's not another one could take your place. Babyface, my poor heart is jumping. You sure have started something off, baby face. I'm up in heaven when I'm in your fond embrace. I didn't need a shove, cause I just fell in love with your pretty baby face. Babyface, I'm up in heaven when I'm in your fond embrace. You're like a breath of spring that makes old Jolie sing about your baby face.
Say, Al.
Yes, Oscar?
I want to thank you for that Easter necktie you gave me. It was very nice.
Oh, Oscar, it was nothing. I wanted to get you some for Easter, but I didn't know what, because I didn't know what would go with that same tired suit you wear every week. But I'm really glad you like that hand-painted tie.
I like hand-painted ties.
Yeah?
But did you have to give me one with your picture on it?
Well, when I look at you, I like to look at me.
Now,
yeah.
I think people are too close conscious nowadays.
Nowadays, he says. It's always been that way, Oscar. For your information, the Duke of Wellington wasn't allowed to attend a formal at the Almack Club in London because he was wearing white duck trousers. And that was 150 years ago.
What did you wear to the party?
Listen, Smarty, I didn't go.
Smarty pants.
Yeah, Smarty pants. I didn't go. They were getting ready for the Battle of Waterloo, and I was registering at my draft board.
Al.
Yeah?
No matter what kind of suit I wear, the piano bench wears it out.
Really?
The seat of my suit is so shiny.
Thank you.
Do you mind if I do that?
Go ahead, yeah.
The seat of my suit is so shiny, when I go out, I have to powder it.
Oscar, how about going to the piano and shining up your suit with Altwien, which means O Vienna, by Leopold Godowsky.
Is your family the kind that likes a snack before bedtime? Well, if they do, you should keep on hand a package of Kraft's wonderfully digestible cheese food, Velveeta. Then when Dad and the kids start prowling in the refrigerator, let them spread or slice that nutritious Velveeta thick for whatever kind of snack suits their fancy. Or if you have visitors, get out the sandwich grill. In a jiffy, you'll fix hot golden brown sandwiches just oozing with Velveeta's golden cheddar cheese goodness. Velveeta's the perfect idea for snacks or sandwiches any time of the day or night. You see, this favorite cheese food is digestible as milk itself and rich in valuable milk nutrients. Tomorrow, get the 2-pound loaf or at least several half-pound packages of genuine Velveeta.
Oscar, that's very nice. You know, you play Rachmaninoff's variations on a theme of Paganini beautifully.
Now, you surprise me. How did you know that that was Rachmaninoff's variations on a theme of Paganini?
Well, to tell the truth, I've been a little embarrassed about not knowing the better music, so last night I was up most of the night studying up on it. Now I know everything that was written, whether it was by Rachmaninoff, Tchaikovsky, Debussy, Mendelssohn, or any one of those guys.
That's wonderful, Al. Then you should recognize this.
Oscar,
yeah?
Play it again, will you? No. I don't think I know that one.
That's the Spring Song by Mendelssohn.
Oh, something you wrote today, huh?
Al, Mendelssohn is dead.
Isn't it marvelous how those fellas can go on writing under those conditions? But you see, Oscar, when I think of a spring song, I think of something I can sing. You know about flowers, birds, bees, trees.
Trees. How does trees go?
I think that I shall never see a poem lovelier as a tree.
That's too high class a tree for me. There's something else, too.
Al, here's a Clyhas tree that grows right in your own backyard.
In the shade of the old apple tree, where the love in your eyes I could see, when the voice that I heard, like the song of the bird, seemed to whisper sweet music to me. I could hear the dull buzz of the bee in the blossoms that you said to me. With a heart that is true, I'll be waiting for you in the shade of the old apple tree.
Wonderful, Al. Nobody sings those songs like you do.
Thank you, Oscar.
Of course, nobody wants to.
Now, Oscar, please, why do you rib me for singing old songs? The music you play was written over 200 years ago. And don't tell me I was there when it was written.
I wasn't going to say you were there when it was written. You were on tour at that time.
I opened my trap and fall in a trap.
Anyway, I just don't play old pieces. How about Pachatorian Saber Dance?
Oscar, please.
Al, I just wanted to remind the people I have a record out.
Oh, that's right. By the way, how is that Saber Dance record selling?
The records aren't going very fast.
No?
But they're selling a lot of sabers.
I'm glad to hear it. It'll help my field stock. But look, don't kid me about singing old tunes. The reason we do so many of them is because the people like to hear them. Now, just today, I got a request from a barber at the club, and he wants me to sing the Road to Mandalay. So give me a pompous arpeggio, please.
On
to the road to Mandalay. Where the flying tickets play.
Al, Al. Huh? Don't strain yourself.
Who strained myself?
That's enough for a cliche. Al.
Yeah.
Here's a dollar. Get yourself a haircut.
Thanks, Oscar, but isn't this dollar awfully new?
Why?
It's got MacArthur's picture on it.
Well, there's an ambitious Republican in the Mint.
Oscar, changing the subject as clumsily as I can.
Thank you.
How is it you never play Liebestraum by Liszt?
How is it you never sing Shine on Harvest Moon by Liszt?
Well, look, you promised me never to play Liebestraum, and I'll sing Shine on Harvest Moon, okay?
That's one of the most attractive offers I've ever had.
Shine on a harvest moon. Up in the sky, I had no loving since April, January, June, or July. Snow time ain't no time to stay outside and spoon. So shine on a harvest moon. For me and my girl.
Say, Al, a fella just delivered a dress suit backstage. He says it's for you.
Oh, yeah, that's just what I've been waiting for. You see, I'm getting ready to go to that big society party given by Mr. Atwater Kent.
Al, you were invited to Atwater Kent?
Yes, I was. And I guess you know that Atwater Kent doesn't invite just anybody.
Well, I always thought so, up until now.
Now, don't worry about me, because I'm going to be the belle of the ball.
Isn't a girl usually the belle of the ball?
Well, when Jolie is there, they relax the rules a little.
I beg your pardon, Mr. Jolson. Don't you remember me?
You? Why, well, I don't know.
Go back 35 years to middle age.
Oh, yes, you're Clifton Webb. Of course, I should have known you. You haven't changed.
You have.
What? Wait a minute, Clifton. Don't be kidding me about my age. Remember, you're not exactly a boy.
He's not exactly a girl, either.
Mr. Jolson, would you introduce me to this person so I can snub him?
First happy moment I've had on the show. Oh, sure. Oscar Levant, Clifton Webb.
Well, since we're on the air, I guess I have to say hello.
Oh, yes, Mr. Levant. I believe I've heard you play the piano off and on. As I recall, you were more off than on.
Mr. Webb, it would be unfair of me to enter into a battle of wits with you. You're not fully armed. A goodbye.
A goodbye. Goodbye, Mr. Levant. I'm sorry we can't continue our conversation.
That's okay. I'll listen in and listen to you on Juvenile Jury.
You're fine. With proper makeup, I could appear on that program, too.
Oh, stop kidding yourself, Clifton. I remember you way back when you danced in my show at the Winter Garden. That was 34 years ago.
Yes, the critics all said they'd never seen a six-month-old baby dance so well.
Six-month-old baby. Clifton, let's be honest and frank about it. Both of us are on the shady side of 40.
Shady side of 40?
Yeah.
Where we are, it's positively pitch black.
What does it matter, Clifton? Years don't make any difference.
People still want to see me.
Mm.
Now you know, I don't like to brag.
If you didn't, you'd be out of character.
Clifton, please. It so happens that I've been invited to a party at Atwater Kent.
I know, that's why I'm here.
Really?
Yes, I've got to teach you the proper things to say and do.
But I didn't send for you to teach me anything.
I know, your wife did.
Clifton, I don't like to say this to you because I don't think it's nasty enough. But if you'll leave quickly, I promise not to cry.
I'm sorry, Jolson, but I've been neglecting my duty if I left now. It's very important in a social affair of this type for you to be a good conversationalist.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what, for instance, would you talk about?
Well, I talk about the thing that interests me most in the whole world.
I mean, after you're through talking about yourself.
Are there any other subjects?
Oh, let's see. I give up now, but your wife begged me to come over and try to do something about your dancing.
I don't understand my wife. I've been dancing for years.
I know, but she's tired of the minuet.
Well, I don't care about these new dances like the Charleston and the bunny hug.
I can see now that I have raw material. Now, first, Jolson, there's etiquette involved in asking a young lady to dance.
Of course.
Now, say that you're at Atwater Kent's.
Mm-hmm.
You're in the ballroom and you see Lana Turner.
Yes.
Naturally, you want to dance. So, what do you say to her?
Well, I'd say, Miss Turner, would you like to sit this one out?
Jolson, you don't ask a young lady to sit one out until after you've danced with her.
I don't fight preliminaries.
Well, I can see there's only one way to show you. Now, we'll pretend that I'm Lana Turner.
All right, Clifton. You're Lana Turner.
On second thought, forget that I'm Lana Turner. That glint in your eye frightens me. Now, perhaps it'd be better if you're Lana Turner, and I'll pretend that I'm you. Oh, that poor Larry Parks, what he went through. Now, I have to ask you to dance. Notice I place my hand very lightly on your back.
Yes.
That's because you're wearing a strapless gown.
What's holding it up?
Thumbtacks.
Clifton, I don't think I need your help. You notice Mr. Atwater Kent invited me, not you.
I'll get it. Hello? Oh, yes, yes. Oh, very well, I'll tell him. That was Atwater Kent.
Atwater Kent? What did he say?
You won't have to be at the party. He had to pay a little more, but he's got another singer. Hoagy Carmichael.
Here's a quick trick every homemaker should have up her sleeve, especially this last week in Lent. It's the Velveeta recipe for making smooth, rich cheese sauce in a hurry. All you do is melt 1/2 pound of Kraft's famous cheese food in the top of the double boiler. And then when the Velveeta's melted, stir in 1/4 cup of milk. And there, that easily, you've made a cheese sauce that's so rich-tasting, so smooth, so wonderful, it'll do credit to the most expert chef. Toss in some shrimp or crab meat or lobster, and you have a real party dish. Serve Velveeta sauce on vegetables, and you'll find you've discovered the trick of making the family vegetable enthusiasts. But tomorrow, for your Good Friday dinner or lunch, we suggest you use this nutritious, grand-eating Velveeta sauce on fish or eggs for the main dish. Just be sure to get genuine, smooth-melting Velveeta, and you simply can't miss at making a wonderful cheese sauce. Smart homemakers usually buy Velveeta in the 2-pound loaf that keeps them stocked for hot dishes as well as snacks and sandwiches.
Folks, there are certain songs that we associate with certain holidays. And Easter wouldn't be complete without Irving Berlin's Easter Parade.
In your Easter bonnet, with all the frills upon it, you'll be the grandest lady in the Easter parade. I'll be all in clover, and when they look you over, I'll be the proudest fellow in that Easter parade. On the avenue, I'm talking about this avenue, the photographer will snap us, and you'll find that you're in the Roto Review. Oh, I could write a sonnet about your Easter bonnet and of the girl I'm dating to that Easter parade.
In your Easter bonnet, with all the frills upon it,
I'll be the grandest lady
in the Easter parade. Oh, I'll be all in clover, and when they look you over,
you'll be the proudest fellow
in the Easter parade.
the avenue. I'm talking about this avenue. The photographers will snap us, and you'll find that you're in the roto gravure. I could write a sonnet about that Easter bonnet and of the girl I'm taking to that Easter.
In the Kraft Music Hall, it's an Easter tradition to hear from the Kraft Choral Club in Chicago. These 80 men and women who sing together for the joy of making music have come to be known as one of the finest non-professional choral groups in the Middle West. Tonight, under the direction of Gerhard Schroth, they have for us an Easter selection called Sheep and Lambs. For the Kraft Choral Club, we now take you to Chicago. Thank you. In behalf of all of us in the music hall, I want to thank the Kraft Call Group of Chicago on the beautiful rendition of Sheep and Lambs. And a happy Easter to everyone. May I say good night, folks.
Clifton Webb may currently be seen as the star of the 20th Century Fox production, Sitting Pretty. Tune in again next Thursday for the Kraft Music Hall, starring Al Jolson with Oscar Levant, Lou Bring and his orchestra and chorus, and our special guest, Jimmy Durante. This is Ken Carpenter saying goodnight. Stay tuned into this station to hear Jack Carson with Eve Arden, who'll follow immediately. Also, tune in to Greg Gildersleeve next Wednesday on this network. Remember, next Thursday's guest on Kraft Music Hall will be Jimmy Durante.
There's loads of hidden flavor in those leftover dishes, ladies. Smart housewives bring it out the easy, tasty way. They use Kraft prepared mustard. It adds that extra flavor tang to casserole dishes, to salad dressing. It peps up cold meats and sandwiches. Now, there are two kinds, you know. Delicately spiced golden Kraft salad mustard for those who like their mustard smooth and mild. And Kraft mustard with snappy horseradish added. Stock up on both kinds. They'll add zest to every meat dish you serve. Ask your grocer for Kraft prepared mustard.